is again Dr. Raimi Hemram, and in continuation with your last lecture on importance and scope of exotic vegetable cultivation in Jharkhand, this is just the continuation of it. So we'll see, for this lecture we'll see the cultivation of exotic vegetables. So the exotic vegetables, they require cool climate and well-drained fertile soil for its growth, and Jharkhand is blessed with a diverse climatic condition, so it can support growing of a wide range of fruits or vegetables. And some of these crops needs to be grown under protected cultivation, like I have told in previous lecture, like capsicum, colored capsicum, red pepper or red bell pepper or yellow bell pepper, then cherry tomato, while some of them can be cultivated in open, like broccoli or Brussels sprout. Now one by one we'll see the cultivation package of practices for individual crop, individual exotic vegetables. First we'll see asparagus. It is also known as shatavar in Hindi, and scientifically it is known as Asparagus officinae. This crop has originated from Europe and then it has been introduced in India, and it is dioecious in nature, means male and female they are different. And the edible part of asparagus is known as pear, and it is perennial in nature, so its lifespan is around 10 to 20 years. And then the benefit of consuming asparagus is that it is rich in folic acid, so it helps in formation of blood cells, and it also prevents liver diseases. Then it is also rich in lutein, which prevents hemorrhage. And pear contains asparagin, which acts as a diuretic in chronic gout. Asparagus is also rich in, it is also low in calories, and so those persons who are suffering from obesity, they can consume it without any problem. And they are rich in potassium, folate and antioxidants. Mostly all the exotic vegetables, they have antioxidant properties. So for soil, it requires fertile loam, which should be high in organic matter, and the pH of the soil should range from 6 to 7.5. And the climate, the day temperature it requires ranges from 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, and night temperature should be around 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. There are three types of asparagus based on the color, white, based on the color of the spear portion, that is white, green or purple. For commercial cultivation, mainly the male plants are used, and male varieties are, for example, Jersey Giant, Jersey Knight, and hybrids which are male, they are Greenwich, Jersey Gem, Jersey Titan, Jersey King. For seed rate, it is 3 to 4 kg per hectare. It should be planted, it should be planted in March to April in hills areas and in hilly areas, and in July to November in plains. The spacing for planting is row to row spacing is 50 and plant to plant spacing is 50 centimeter, and higher spacing is required in case of white asparagus, because they might be spreading in nature. And for fertilization, FYM 20 tons per hectare is required, and nitrogen 80 to 120 kg, phosphorus 80 to 100 kg, and potassium 60 to 80 kg per hectare, that is to be given twice in a year. For harvesting, since asparagus is a perennial crop, so multiple harvesting can be done, and but still the per plant only 8 spears should be harvested, so that the plant may not exhaust its all resources. And it is preferable that the first harvesting should be done 2 years after planting. And at the time of the harvesting, it should be noted that the spear should not be elongated too much, otherwise it will become fibrous, and the head should be compact, and it should not fern out. Fern out means, fern out is the mechanism in which the spear head, it will lose its compactness, and this phenomena is also known as feathering. This is mainly due to the lengthening of the internode. So at the time of the harvest, spear length, it should be around 20 centimeter, and it should not be allowed to grow more than 22.5 centimeter, otherwise it will not be marketable. The yield for asparagus is 25 to 40 quintals per hectare. Next come broccoli. Broccoli is scientifically known as Brassica oleracea var italica, and it is used as a salad. It can be consumed after cooking, and it has carcinogenic and antioxidant properties. Like, it is anti-cancerous, and it has also anti-aging properties. The edible part of broccoli is the head portion, and along with the stem attached to it. And it contains sulforaphane, which is known to have anti-cancerous properties. Right. Then soil, loamy soil with pH 5 to 6.5 is suitable for its growth, and temperature of around 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. And for head development, the temperature at the time of head development, the temperature should be around 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. Seed trade is 400 to 500 grams per hectare, and the sowing of broccoli seeds takes place is mainly done during August to September at a spacing of row to row spacing of 45 to 60 centimeter and plant to plant spacing of 30 to 50 centimeter. For fertilization, it requires FYM application of 20 tons per hectare. Then for urea, around 300 kg, SSP 500 kg, and MOP 100 kg. Apart from the major nutrients, some micronutrients are also applied, like molybdenum 500 gram or borax 10 to 15 kg per hectare. For harvesting, the lower flower, the flower buds open and loosen, and for harvesting, before the flower loosen up, it has to be harvested, and the head portion along with the shoot portion, adjoining shoot portion, is consumed. So it is it is harvested along with a little bit of shoot, and some of the side shoots, they are left, like from the curd portion, the side shoots are there left, and to obtain the seeds, and the main central region is only harvested. Yield of broccoli is around 15 to 20 tons per hectare, and varieties like Palam Samriddhi, Pusa KTS1 can be grown. Next is your kale, which is kale and collard, which is scientifically known as Brassica oleracea var acephala, or for collard, scientifically it is known as Brassica oleracea var viridis. So these two crops, they have originated from Mediterranean region and then introduced in India, and their edible part is mostly the leafy portion along with the little shoot, and both have this anti-carcinogenic properties, anti-inflammatory. They are rich in beta-carotene, and also they are rich in vitamins like K and C, lutein, zeaxanthin, calcium. So it is very highly nutritious, this kale and collard. For soil, sandy loam with pH 5.5 to 6.5 is suitable, and it requires cool winter, and it can withstand minus 10 to minus 15 degrees Celsius. Seed rate is around 400 to 500 grams per hectare, and for planting, spacing is required 60 to 90 centimeter row to row spacing and 45 to 60 plant to plant spacing. It is sown in the month of October to November in plains, and in August to September in hilly areas. FYM is given at the rate of 20 to 25 tons per hectare, and NPK is given at the rate of 150:75:75, nitrogen 150, phosphorus 75, and potassium 75 kg per hectare. For harvesting, in kale, the entire plant is cut 40 days after transplanting, and or either you can pick the lower leaves at certain intervals. In collard, what is done, all the green parts, they are harvested, and after they have attained 25 to 30 centimeter height. The yield in kale and collard, it is similar. It is around 15 to 20 tons per hectare, and the popular varieties are dwarf moss curled and hamburger market. So you can see the difference between kale and collard. Next crop is your lettuce. Lettuce is scientifically known as Lactuca sativa. Lettuce is scientifically named as Lactuca sativa. It is also originated from Mediterranean region, and the edible part is also your leafy head portion. It is known as king of green salad, and and it is used as in the form of salad. It is consumed in soup, in sandwiches and wraps, and it is low in calories and therefore it is an effective diet food. It also has certain medicinal properties, like it is cardioprotective, it is good for your heart, and it is anti-allergic and rich in vitamin A, C and carotene. So it requires well-drained soil having pH 6.8, and it is highly sensitive to acidic soil. Jharkhand soil is acidic, so intervention needs to be done before taking up lettuce. You need to apply lime, and the suitable temperature is around 13 to 16 degree Celsius. Seed rate of lettuce is 400 to 500 grams per hectare, and sowing time in plain it is September to October. Row to row spacing is 45 centimeter, plant to plant spacing is 45 centimeter, and 10 tons of per hectare well decomposed FYM is applied, and then for nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium 25:90:25 kg per hectare is applied. Okay, for harvesting lettuce, it is harvested when the leaves and heads they are mature enough, and then if the temperature rises, then the leaves will become bitter in taste. The yield of lettuce is 10 to 15 tons per hectare, and there are five types of lettuce. First one is crisp head. In crisp head lettuce, they have head type with wrinkled non-wrapper leaves which are brittle in texture. And one of the example of this variety is Great Lakes. This is your crisp head. Then next is your butter head. Butter head will have a loose head, and the texture of its leaves is little bit oily and soft, not brittle as in case of crisp head. Then another type of lettuce is your coarse or romaine. They have mainly elongated leaves which will give it a loaf type of bread loaf type of shape. Then fourth type of variety is your leaf or bunching type. They are non-heading type of lettuce which produces a rosette of leaves. And example of this leaf or bunching type of lettuce is Chinese yellow or slow bold. Then the last type of lettuce is your stem type, which produces thick stem. And since they produce a thick stem, they needs to be peeled before consumed. The next crop is your parsley, which is scientifically known as Petrosalinum crispum. This parsley is used in the form of salad, and it is also used for flavoring or garnishing meat, soup, sauces, stews. And parsley is rich in iron, potassium, vitamin E, C, B, and it also has anti-carcinogenic properties. There are three types of varieties in case of parsley, like plain leaf, for example, deep green banquet emerald, double curled, giant Italian, deep green Italian, and moss curled. So here in pictures you can see plain leaf, it almost looks like coriander, and then your double curled looks like Aralia, and moss curled, it looks somewhat like moss, that normal moss. Then for its cultivation it requires well-drained soil with pH 5.5 to 6.8. The seed rate of parsley is 250 to 300 gram per hectare, and in plain areas it is sown in the month of September to November, and in hill areas it is sown in the month of March to May. It is planted at the distance of row to row distance of 30 to 60, and planting distance for plant to plant is 10 to 15 centimeter. 15 tons of well decomposed FYM per hectare is applied, and nitrogen 60 kg per hectare, phosphorus 40, potassium 30 kg per hectare is applied. At the time of harvesting, mainly the outer larger leaves, they are picked periodically, and then they are made into bunches for the sale in market. The yield for partially, it varies from 15 to 20 tons per hectare when you are taking only fresh herb. But if you are using, it is also used in the dry form, mainly for flavoring or garnishing. So when in harvesting in the dried form, the yield, it will be around 20 to 30 quintals per hectare. Next is your cherry tomato. Cherry tomato is scientifically known as Solanum lycopersicum var. Cerasi formi. So this cherry tomato, it is highly rich in flavonoids and flavonoid content as compared to the normal tomato. So then it is also considered good for heart and blood pressure and bones. And cherry tomato, it should be mainly cultivated under protected cultivation at a spacing of around 15 to 50 centimeter. And they are, before sowing, it is raised in nursery or in pro trays. And seedlings which are having 5 to 6 true leaves, they are then transplanted into the main field. So in case of cherry tomato, this staking and pruning is crucial. So staking is mainly done with the bamboo stick or with the help and on which they are twined with the helper and then binded with the thread. Then around two fruiting stem is kept per plant. And when they are completely ripened red in color, then they are harvested along with the calyx. So it will give some aesthetic look to the this cherry tomato fruit. Next is your Chinese cabbage. Chinese cabbage is scientifically known as Brassica rapa var pekinensis, or another one is known as chinensis. Chinensis is your bok choy or pak choy. So pekinensis group, commonly known as Napa cabbage, or the chinensis group, that is your bok choy. These are used in the form of they are used to make kimchi. Kimchi is a South Korean delicacy. Then they can be either cooked or they can be made into salad, and they are rich in calcium, vitamin A and vitamin C. So it requires fertile soil with pH around 6.8 to 7.8, and the favorable temperature varies from 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. The seed rate for Chinese cabbage is 400 to 500 per gram per hectare. And FYM at the rate of 10 tons per hectare is applied, and nitrogen 75 kg per hectare, phosphorus 30 kg per hectare, and potassium 30 kg per hectare is applied. So the sowing time for Chinese cabbage is around October to November, and with a spacing of either 45 into 30 centimeter or 25 into 25 centimeter. So for harvesting, the whole head of the Chinese cabbage is cut when they are still compact and firm. The yield of Chinese cabbage is 25 to 50 tons per hectare. Then next come your capsicum or your colored peppers, scientifically known as capsicum annuum. So it is either cooked or they can be cooked or eaten raw, or they can be stuffed with some masala or other things, and then they are highly used in salad and pizzas. So the sowing time for capsicum in case of poly house, it is around November, and it is also sown in the month of August during autumn winter season, and in November for spring summer season. Then the seed rate for this autumn winter, August sowing is done when the harvest is required for autumn winter season. Okay, then for spring summer harvest, it is sown in November. Then seed rate for capsicum is 1.25 kg per hectare, same as in case of chili, around the same. Then spacing is plant to plant, row to row spacing is 45 to 60 centimeter, and plant to plant spacing is 30 to 45 centimeter. So when the fruits have become firm or crispy and somewhat of marketable size, they are harvested, and the yield of capsicum varies from around 12 to 15 tons per hectare of OP variety, and for hybrid varieties it is 25 to 30 tons per hectare. Then next come your sweet corn. Sweet corn, scientifically known as Gia maize. Corn var, Saccharata corn var, means it is an interspecific hybrid, and var rugosa. So varieties such as Sholan Sugar Baby and Golden Baby, they are popular, and the seed rate for sweet corn is 30 to 40 kg per hectare. Sowing time is, it is sown during February March at a spacing of 60 cm row to row and 15 cm plant to plant. So well decomposed 10 to 20 tons of FIM is required for 1 hectare, and 100 kg nitrogen, 50 kg of phosphorus and 30 kg of potassium per hectare is required, is applied. Then it is harvested 45 to 50 around 2 months after sowing, when they are around, that cob is around 8 to 10 centimeter in length. The yield for sweet corn is around 10 to 12 quintals per hectare. Then next come your red cabbage, which is your Brassica oleracea var capitata, then subvar rubra. The popular variety for red cabbage is your red rock, red drumhead, kinner red, and seed rate is around 350 to 450 grams per hectare, and it is sown during October to November in plains and in April to May in hills. So there are two set of spacing. First is your 45 into 45 centimeter, row to row 45, then plant to plant 45, or either row to row 60 and plant to plant 35 centimeter. Then 15 tons of well decomposed FIM per hectare is applied, and then nitrogen in the form of CAN, calcium ammonium nitrate, is applied for 480 kg per hectare. Phosphorus in the form of SSP, if you are taking, it is 315 kg per hectare, and potash, if you are taking in the form of MOP, muriate of potash, then it is 45 kg per hectare. The cropping period of a red cabbage is around 1 year, 12 to 15 weeks, that means after sowing, and its yield is around 10 to 15 tons per hectare. So these are the crops which has been dealt for under exotic vegetable cultivation. So thank you for listening. Thank you very much.